always think the biggest challenge of any artist is how to frame the important questions that you have that are immediate and urgent, but to allow a sense of timelessness and universality. I was only 17 when I came to this country, and my early obsession was to look back at my past, and the work became about a projection of my own obsession. After I've lived in this country and became a sort of a nomad on this planet, I noticed that my attention and my lenses shifted from Iran to other parts of the world, and now finally landed in a country where I've called home. I think that with every one of these portraits, there is a sense of dignity that I think that is shared in every single face, but at the same time, a lot of vulnerability. And that kind of duality is how I see life and how I see myself. When I look back at these images, I really think that they capture the humanity behind these people, regardless of what is their ethnic and religious background. And they really, in my opinion, become a true depiction of what America looks like today. In light of one of the most difficult historical years, people are really looking for films that are able to reflect on some of the issues we're facing about race, about health crisis, about political upheavals, but all within a language that gives you a sense of hope and inspiration. A lot of artists are suffering from losing their opportunity of exhibitions or audiences because of COVID, but I think all of this will hopefully lead to a better place where we as artists question the role that art and culture plays in the moment of crisis. One of the things that I will look to in the future is the acceptance of uncertainty, the not knowing what will be tomorrow, whether we'll be safe, whether we'll be alive. That has to be part of our grammar in the future. We just always have to strive for something better, of course, but there's no guarantee. And I think as long as you accept that and you're prepared, then we'll be in a better place.